In this video, I'm going to show you how to customize your email footer in ConvertKit, which is the absolute best email marketing tool if you wish to add additional text or links to the footer. And don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Welcome to Yes to Tech, where we empower non-techie online entrepreneurs like you to maximize your online presence. First of all, if you don't have a ConvertKit account yet, click the link in the description box below to create your account right away. To customize your email footer in ConvertKit, you need to access the email template page. To get here, click on this button over here on the top right-hand corner, select Account Settings, and then from the top right, click on Email Templates. ConvertKit comes with these three templates by default, and you can see down here the template that I customized. If you've never customized a template before, don't worry. All we have to do is copy the code of one of these existing templates and edit it to suit our needs. My favorite out of the three ConvertKit templates is this modern one over here. So I'm going to go ahead and click on that one. You'll notice that the code over here is grayed out and that you aren't able to edit it. ConvertKit does this on purpose so you don't mistakenly mess up with its default option. Now let's go ahead and select the entire piece of code and press Ctrl C or Command C to copy it. Once you've done that, click on All Templates right above the template's name to go back to the screen where we were previously. What we'll do now is create a new template with the same exact code, but where we'll edit the footer. So go ahead and click on the blue New Email Template button on the right. Name your template whatever you wish. And paste the code we had copied in the template HTML space provided. Now let's edit the code so that we customize our footer. Scroll all the way down the HTML box until you locate the line of code that says footer, right over here. You'll notice that this footer section starts with div and ends with a /div over here. This means that anything that's between these two lines, which is this section, will appear in our footer. Right now, if I click on Preview Layout on the right, you'll notice that in my footer, I have an unsubscribe link and my address. So one thing that we can do over here to customize our footer is add some text around the unsubscribe link, which is all of this over here. So let's do that. For instance, you can add the words click here to before the unsubscribe link and from all mailings right after. You can also edit the word unsubscribe to something else by editing just this section over here to something like to be permanently removed, or to the word unsubscribe with all letters in lowercase. If you wish to view the changes we just made, click on Preview Layout on the right-hand side. You'll see that the words we just added, click here to unsubscribe from all mailings, now appear in the footer. Okay, so say that you want to insert a link to your email footer. To do so, just add the piece of text that you wish. For example, or click here to follow Yes to Tech on Pinterest. Now, before the words that you want to be a link, in my case, click here to follow Yes to Tech on Pinterest, add an open bracket, the letter A, space, and then the letters H, R, E, F, an equal sign, quotation mark, another quotation mark, and between these two quotation marks over here is where we'll add the URL of our link, close bracket, and then at the very end of our word or phrase that we want to be linked, so over here, add an open bracket again, forward slash, the letter A, and a close bracket. So let's just preview what we just did. You'll see here that click here to follow Yes to Tech on Pinterest is now a link. Now, all you need to do is add what you want that to be linked to between the quotation marks. So let's go over here and add that link. And that's it. If you preview the layout again and click on click here to follow Yes to Tech on Pinterest, you'll be redirected to Yes to Tech's Pinterest profile. Once you're happy making edits to your footer, click on Save on the bottom right to save the template you just created. To ensure that the template you just created is the default one used for all your ConvertKit mailings, click on Use this template below the template you just created. And you'll see here that your active template is the one that will have the green tick next to it. So now you know how to customize your email footer in ConvertKit with text and links. Again, if you don't have a ConvertKit account yet, just click the link in the description box below to create your account right away. I now want to hear from you. Let me know in the comments below what custom text and links you added to your own ConvertKit footer. If you're interested in learning about even more brilliant tools you can use to run your online business, make sure to download the free cheat sheet with the 9 absolute best tools to run your online business by clicking on the link in the description box below. If you liked this video, give me a like below, share it with your friends, and make sure to subscribe and hit the bell to be notified every time we post a new video. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.